All right, guys, Good Boy 32 here. Check it out. What we're looking at is my little AR-15 pistol. This is a 10.5-inch barrel. If you watched the video last week, we were testing this, the Primo targets out with this guy. We were shooting out to 300 yards, making contact about 50% of the time. Well, maybe a little less than that. But because I really didn't know what was going on with the optic and how it was going to relate to the drop out to 300 yards. 200 yards was very easy. 100, it was a dead bean. But anyway, what we did was we were testing out the Primo targets using the Sig Sauer 5XDR sent out to us by Optics Planet. Now, there's a discount code below. If you want to buy stuff from Optics Planet, use that discount code. You get 5% off your total order. This is a special deal by Sig Sauer. This is the Op Mod. And I tell you what, I have been terribly impressed with this thing. And a lot of people have asked me what the difference is between this guy, and I wish I had it with me, but the Romeo 5. There's a couple differences, and we're going to go over those things. And yes, they are justifiable in the increase in the cost with this thing right here. But what this video is about is this guy right here, the Juliet 4. Now, I wanted to do a box opening with this thing. You saw how it worked out there in the field, and it's just like any other flip side magnifier. But this guy, a couple things that really jumped out at me is the clarity of the optic. It was really nice. Also the mount that flipped to the side, it was very, very crisp and clean. All right, so a couple of the features: 90 degree power cam, quick flip away mount for fast transitions from near to far distance targets, quick release mount with built-in recoil lugs. That's one of the things I did like about this. There's a lug inside of this guy that locks it into the pick rail. Front thread in lens protector and rear flip up back protection from the elements. And they are, it is glass. Aircraft grade CNC aluminum housing, IPX8, which means it can go to 20 meters for 1 hour. Dielectric coating, coated prism, compact size, adjustable height, risers in the package here, and infinite guarantee. See website for full details. Yeah, I like this thing a whole lot, and I'm going to show you some photos that I took of the glass through this thing. But anyway, it comes in a really nice box. Got it protected. Here's your instruction manual here. Goes through all the details of what to do, how to do it, alignment of the optic. Here's some additional screws. Here is a replacement front lens. Here's the different thickness risers, so you can go 1/3 lower co-witness, absolute co-witness, and even go higher than that. Here is your Allen wrench. Now let's pull this bad boy out and I will show you exactly what we're looking at. Here we go, stand by. First thing I want to show to you is that these dials right here, this is how you align the reticle inside the optic itself. So you can move the object up and down, left and right, by utilizing these things right here. One of the cool things I do like is that you can use any one of a spent shell casing. The clicks are pronounced, as you can hear right there. Now, I put this thing on and it just came to the middle. I didn't have to do anything. Here's the cool thing. You do have lens protectors front and rear. These do come out. These are made of glass, and that way you can go ahead and you can pull these things out. And here's a replacement. You can go in it just like this. There is also the, and the reason you've got to have these right here and they're made of glass is because, and I'll show you here in a second, you have to put these things on. And the reason that they're like this and they are rubber sealed is that you're going to be right up against the red dot. The backside, this is glass also, and it's held in with a little C-clamp right here, as you can see. The rear glass is absolutely phenomenal. One of the things I was really impressed with is, guys, this is, I think, like a $350 magnifier if you bought it on its own. Is it worth it? I'd say it's built just as good as anything out there, if not better. The diopter on the back, you can adjust it so you can see the reticles clean and clear. There is a locking QD amount right here. See, it will not come out. You depress that little thing right there, and there you go. Now, what we were talking about, the locking lugs that are also on the red dot itself, are these guys right here. See those? That they lock into the pick rail as well as this guy right here. There is adjustments there. I didn't have any issues going ahead and putting it on. Now let's go ahead and put it on a rifle and I'll show you what we're talking about. So anyway, what I did was I wanted to go ahead and get it as close to the optic as I could. That lines up absolutely perfect right there. Also, I like for any of my scopes, any of my magnifiers to be flush with the backside of the charging handle and or the backup iron sights. When you lock this thing in place, you've got these three locking lugs right here. And you can see how those go in between the pick rail. And when you lock this bad boy down, it's in. It's not going anywhere. Now watch this. See how nice that is? That is really nice. And the cool thing is, watch this. If I need to go to backups, right there they are. It clears it all. This is a fine package. All in all, I will tell you this. This optic with this magnifier will stay on this firearm. And that's all I got to say about that. But look at that. See how well that looks? But altogether, I think the total package with this as it comes together, you can get it for about $549. I know that's a lot of money, but it is well worth it when you're talking about a complete package. A lot of optics out there today, you're going to spend over $500 just on the optic. But you got a top-notch lineup with these guys from SIG. In any case, one of the things I did forget to, or failed to point out on the initial video is you do have directionals right here and here on the optic itself. And that's, again, one of the cool things is you can take a spent casing and turn those just like that. And as a whole package, this setup right here, along with that light, very, very nice firearm indeed. Guys, that's it. God bless the red, white, and blue. God bless America. God bless those men and women in uniform 24/7 for our freedom. This Freedom's Not Free reflective video, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already done so. And that's about it. Give me a thumbs up. As you can see, it's nitrogen charged right there. That's the plug. But look at that. Bam. Bam. Good boy 32. I'm out. Y'all be good.